Greetings, friends. Sonic Toast here. Ba-ba-da-ba. We got Mephiles to look at today. Let's see. This is amazing. This is our first ever Mephiles figure, even though this character has been around since 2006. He's had a plushie from GE, and I think that's about it as far as merchandise. 11 points of articulation. Let's take a look at his character description. It says, Mephiles is the darker half of the fire deity Solaris and an enemy to humanity's future. Bum, bum, bum. Scary. Here is Mephiles out of the box, and look at the fantastic sculpt on this figure. Look at those quills. Look at all the little cracks and everything that are sculpted into every inch of this figure. He looks amazing. Look how they're even in his eyes and they stop when it gets to the pupils. He looks fantastic. I am seriously impressed with how much effort Jack Specific put into the sculpt of this figure. I also appreciate that he appears to have somewhat, you know, like normal looking feet, as the plush just kind of has these little nubs for feet, which I think that may be accurate for the character. However, as far as action figures go, is having little knobs for feet doesn't work too well, although they did give him an accessory that he clicks into. I thought that's what they were going to do, is just have this be his only means of standing up, but I'm happy that he can stand up without it. Here he is inside of his purple flamey thing, and it looks really great. It just does. I mean, I'm so happy they decided to give him an accessory like this rather than just having him come with a spring or a Chaos Emerald or something, you know, very generic that a lot of figures come with. This is great. As far as articulation goes, he has shoulder and wrist articulation, he has legs, he has knees, and he twists at the boot, or whatever you might call this part, and of course his head moves left and right. Now, in terms of proportions, he looks fantastic. He is pretty much perfectly proportioned to Sonic and the rest of the figures. And here's Mephiles chilling with his futuristic homies, Blaze and Silver. Of course, when they knew him, he was in his like form where he looks like Shadow, like a gray version of Shadow. I wonder if they'll make that figure. That would be great if they did an official Mephiles figure in his Shadow form, because all they need to do is just do a repaint of the existing Shadow figure, and heck, I'd buy it for sure. Oh, Mephiles, the one villain who canonically killed Sonic the Hedgehog just for the events of his game to be wiped from the canon. Oh, rabbits. I mean, Mephiles is such an interesting character, the way that there's so many safeguards around him, around using him. I remember in the Archie comics, like, he made nothing but like little background cameos or off-panel cameos, and that was it. Like, he would never play a role in that comic, which like tried to entail like every character ever, you know? However, it seems that Sega has been much more lenient, having Mephiles now appear in like Sonic Forces Speed Battle, Sonic Dash. Was he in Sonic Runners? I think he was in Sonic Runners, wasn't he? I wish we still had Sonic Runners. That was a good game. Yeah, and now we have an action figure, which is just amazing. Well, friends, thank you for watching this quick little review of Mephiles the Dark from Jack Specific. Let me know what you think of this guy down in the comments section. I am just ecstatic that they made this action figure. I'm so happy they're going back and making figures of characters from the older games and letting us add them into our collection. It is so, so great. Thank you, Jack Specific, for doing that. Let us know in the comments if you picked this guy up for your own collection yet, and have a fantastic day. Toast!